Good morning students. Again in this video we will be dealing with the same intransitive and intransitive verb, but we will be learning about the object and the verb of complement, incomplete and complete. Okay, predictions. Okay, now in my first video you have learnt about the transitive and intransitive verb. What are they, what are not, the subject and object, isn't it? Now object you all have already learned, so it is very easy for you to find the object in a sentence. Now children, object is of two types, that is direct object and indirect object. Now how to find these two different types of object? Let's see. To find out direct object you need to ask the question what, that to when to add this or put this question word after verb. And indirect objective you will find out by asking to whom, for whom, after direct object. Okay, after direct object. Now children, this to whom and for whom will be there with the whom. Okay, so it will be easy for you to understand indirect object. Let's clear it out by using the sentences. Now in this sentence, Ram gave the puppy a bowl of milk. What is the verb here? Gave. Yes, gave is our verb. Now what is the subject? What is the subject? I'm asking what, that means Ram. Ram is the subject. Now we have to find out the object, that is direct and indirect. Now when we ask the question what did the Ram gave, what did the Ram give, or Ram gave what to the puppy? Ram gave what? See, I have added the question what after the verb gave. Ram gave what to the puppy? A bowl of milk. What did he give? A bowl of milk. So what is this? Direct object. Okay, Ram gave what to the puppy? Bowl of milk. And to whom he gave? Ram gave what? Ram gave bowl of milk, that is direct. And to whom he gave? The puppy. So this, the puppy is your indirect object. Okay, clear? Mother bought a new dress. Okay, now what is the verb here? Brought. Brought is our verb. And what is the subject? Mother. Okay, who brought the dress? Mother. We are getting the answer. So mother is the subject. Now we will ask question using what. What mother brought? What? Okay, mother bought what, as we have to add what after the verb. Okay, mother bought what? She bought a new dress. So what is this new dress? Direct object. And to whom, for whom? It's not written anything, for whom. So there is no indirect object, it is only direct object. Next, Tina passed the ball to Mohan. What is the verb? Passed. Now who passed the ball to Mohan? Tina. We are getting the answer. So what is this? Tina is your subject. Okay, now Tina passed what? Ball. So what is the ball here, dear? The ball is direct, sorry, the ball is direct object. Okay, and to whom? Mohan. To whom? To Mohan. So what is Mohan? Indirect object. Clear? Last, burn this letter for me. What is the verb here? Burn. Burn is the verb. Okay, now burn this letter for me is your, burn is the verb. Now if I have to find out the direct, what I'll add after the verb? What? Burn what? Letter. So what is the letter? Direct object. Burn what? Letter. So direct object. And for whom? For me. What you have to do? For me. So what is the for me? Indirect object. Have you seen, even indirect, to and for is attached with it. Okay, so is it now easy to find out direct and indirect? Yes, first find out the verb, then ask the question, you will find out the subject. After finding the subject, you know the verb, add the question what after the verb, and when you get an answer, that is direct object. And when you add to whom and for whom after the direct object, then you get the answer, that is your indirect object. I think your direct and indirect object is clear. Okay, now let's move ahead. Okay, now we will deal with verb of complete prediction. Okay, now what is verb of complete prediction? It's predication. And intransitive verb, what is intransitive verb? That does not contain object. Okay, an intransitive verb that makes complete sense on its own is called a verb of complete predication. A baby cries, monkeys jump, girl dances, Meena reads. Now what is the verb here? Cries, jump, dances, reads. The subject is there, the baby, monkeys, girl, Meena. What are these? These are subject, but is there any object? No. So this is an intransitive verb. Now in this intransitive, this verb, they make the complete sense in itself. We don't have to add anything to make it more complete. The baby cries itself is very clear that the baby is crying. Monkeys jump, that monkeys jump. Okay, girl dances, that girl is dancing. Meena reads, that Meena is reading. We don't have to add anything here to make it complete. So this are called verb of complete predication. Okay, they themselves are very complete and they do not have to be added anything to make them complete. They make the complete sense of the sentences and make sure they are the intransitive verb which do not have any object, only the subject. Okay, clear? Now we will see the subject of incomplete predication. This was a complete, now incomplete. Now incomplete itself tell you that it won't be complete. And intransitive verb, this is also will be applicable in intransitive verb that requires a word or a phrase to complete its meaning is called a verb of incomplete predication. Something you need to add more to make it clear. Until unless it's not clear, that is called verb of incomplete predication. Like teacher has selected Raj. Okay, now teacher is subject and selection is your verb. Now something has to be added to make it clear, that is as monitor. Okay, teacher has selected Raj as monitor. So what is this as monitor here? It's an incomplete predication. So this is your verb of incomplete predication. This was your verb of complete predication. This itself has told the meaning of the sentence. Okay, but this has to be added to make this sentence clear. So the one which you add to make it clear, that is called verb of incomplete predication. Okay, so I think both the predications are understandable to you, complete and incomplete. Yes, now let's move ahead with another two topics, that is objective complement and subjective complement. Objective has to be relation with the object and subjective has to be relation with the subject. When we add a complement in a sentence to complete its meaning is called objective complement. When you have to add something in a sentence to make it a complete meaning, okay, that's a complement. What is the meaning of complement? To be added something. Okay, so objective complement, that has to be added with the object to make it clear, that is objective. The council elected Prashant Pradhan. Okay, now council elected Prashant. Election is your verb and this is your subject. So what is the object here? Prashant Pradhan. Now it is incomplete, we have to add president over here. The council elected Prashant Pradhan, president. Okay, so this president is your objective complement, as this makes the objective, your object, more complete. Okay, so it's a complement for your object to make it a complete sense, that is objective complement. Same thing goes here with the subjective. Something which when we add a complement that tells us something about the subject is called subjective complement. Now the girl appears happy, what is the verb here? Appears. Okay, Sanvi is a good girl, good dancer. It's not dancing, it's dancer. So what is the verb here? It is Mohan and Ram are best friends. So what is the verb? Are. Now this R is appears. Tell something about the subject. The girl, Sanvin, Mohan and Ram. These are your subjects. And these words tell you something more about the subject. That girl appears. She seems. Okay. Sanvi is. It means a one girl, that is Sanvi is. Mohan and Ram are. R means for many. So these two are many. So these words tell you something about the subject. Then these words are called subjective complements. Okay. Understood? Subjective, objective complement. And over here we have dealt with complete predication and incomplete predication and direct and indirect object. I think everything is clear to you. Now we are ready to solve the exercises. If you still have any doubt, let me know it. Okay. Thank you.